Today I'll talk about a tool by which you can take screenshot, you can write over it, you can annotate it, you can blur some portion of it. And there are so many functionalities, like you can do GIF recording, you can do screen recording, and you can capture a particular window. So let's begin. So this is my earlier post on a screenshot tool. The speciality of that tool was like it's less than 1 MB and it can just annotate. Like if you see here 300 KB software, and it can just annotate. You cannot blur. And if you want basic, you should use this tool. But if you want to do some advanced things, I'll share another tool with you. So let me show you the functionality first, and then I'll tell you the name of it. And if you're coming first time to my channel, you can subscribe and press the bell icon to keep getting things. So I have three tools in my mind. One I have already covered. Second is this tool, and third I would be covering, which is for a different purpose. So let me show you the functionality. So I have pressed a hotkey, which is a shortcut. So I'm selecting this portion. So as soon as I select that portion, it will open a window for me where I can edit things. So for example, suppose this search button has a problem. So I can highlight this, I can highlight like this, or I can highlight like this as well. So other good functions are, suppose I don't want to show this name, I can blur it. Even there is an option of pixelate, right? Where you don't want exactly blur, but a little less blur, right? And there is another good option, like smart eraser is very good. For example, it detects the color of it and it replaces with the same color, so you won't understand that there was something over there. And you can have free handwriting as well. You want to do stepwise. Sometimes you show that, okay, I clicked here and I'm just clicking it. See, the numbers are automatically generating. And you can press Control Z and all, and you can change things as well. For example, if I draw that arrow, I can select the arrow option again, select this arrow and change its direction. So that is possible. You can add stickers in between. And the other good functionality is highlighter. Like you want to highlight some text. This is not possible in MS Paint. Like there you will struggle to do all this. And there, once you do it, then for going back, you have to press Control Z. You can't edit it. So this is one of the very good functionality of it. So the name of the tool is ShareX. I can show you. ShareX is, it's an open source and free tool, right? It's been there for so many years. Like it was developed 13 years ago, if you can see, and still updates are coming. So I'll tell you some other good features about this tool that you can do. So, and first of all, I'll tell you the base thing that you should do is hotkey settings. So what I do is I just press F7 and a GIF can get recorded, right? So I have, because these keys are rarely used, right? Alt F4, you can maybe change it because it's used with Alt F4, right? So, but F8, F11 and F7 are not used. So whenever I want to capture the screen, I press F8 and that cursor came. Let me show you. Okay, I see a cursor, right? So suppose I want to capture this portion, it's done. F8, it opens for me. Right, so this is important setting. And similarly, if I want to do, the difference between this and this option is here, your voice will also get recorded. It will create a MP4 version of it, but this one will create a GIF. For example, suppose I want to show that this search button, suppose it's not working. So I have pressed F7 and I have selected this portion. So you see a start and abort button is coming, stop and abort. So I'll type something. Testing and say it's not working. I just stopped it, right, to see that how the GIF turns up. So let me open the GIF to show you. So I'm not touching the screen, but you will see that that there is a GIF created, right? So this is GIF. The other option is over there. The other option apart from GIF is the recording option. Right, so let me open the settings. So if I press F11, yeah, you can change these settings, then a video recording would also be can also happen. So I mostly use this capture region function and this GIF if it is smaller, and if you want a MP4 file, you can use this. So select the, make the hotkey settings, and it has various enumerous options. Like Here you can read a QR code on the screen. There is a ruler, right? You can, if you want, upload, like it can upload anywhere. It has integration with Drive, Mega, or OneDrive. All the places you can decide the destinations over here, right? And task settings, you can like what should happen on screen recording. It even allows you a scroll capture. For example, here I can do a scrolling capture, right? So let me share this screen and do start scrolling capturing. So I'm not touching the screen and it has taken the screenshot of the full page. So that is also one of the good functionality this tool provides. And the good part is this hotkey settings, and there are additional tools, and you can define that, and you can even increase the hotkey settings, right? If I want something else, I can click on add and I can like select what I want, upload or screen capture, what kind of screen capture I want. So all these settings are there, and it's really a good tool. I love this tool whenever I want to annotate any files and video recording or GIF, and it's free of cost. So hope you like the video. You can press the subscribe button and the bell icon and wait for the next video where I'll share another tool. There is a purpose which this tool can't solve and that tool can solve. So thanks for watching.